Hey everyone, welcome to Kip TV. I am Kip. Today I got a match for you on Steel. It's between two Steel teams, and I promise that's the last time I'll say Steel like that. Anyway, it is $200 Bullets versus High on Frags. Two North America Steel teams, like I said. Anyway, over in the blue, we have High on Frags. Matman is Engineer Drowning in Butter, a soldier, totally not a bot, is on Heavy. Creme Brulee, that's cute, is Sniper. Gotham is Pyro. Fish Fillet is Spy. Achilles is Scout. 401k is Medic. And PHZ or Fuzz is Demoman. Over on $200 Birds, we have Tater Dude as Pyro. MF Doom is Heavy. Nim is Sniper. Jimmy Hat is Engineer. T Nasty is Scout. Ferris Nova is Spy. The Once and Future King is Soldier. Spooker Senpai is Demoman. And Hiro Protagonist is Medic. So let's get to the action. Why wait? Oh no, that is gonna be annoying. Alright, well, let me see if I can do something. Well, alright, we're just gonna have to deal with it. Oh boy. I guess it's anyone who has an unusual? That'll teach you to have an unusual. Anyway, let's see. So we are here on CP Steel. Both teams were 2-1, I believe, at the time of this match. And it's been about 2 weeks since I've casted, so my cam work is horrible. I'm slowly making my way through the avalanche of cast requests that I have. And I am sorry if I haven't gotten to yours, but I promise I will before I retire. My retirement may be pushed back as I try to finish all these casts. But let's just focus on this one right now as we are here. And looks like the setup, NG has gone for the B defensive setup. For those of you not familiar with Steel, it's the map where I like to say, the map where everything's made up and the points don't matter. That's right, you can cap E at any time you like. Oh man, Once a Future King goes down immediately, so sniped right there, no longer able to patrol that upper area. Nim went down too, sniped as well. So we do see that setup going there at B. Uber has already popped here for blue, and that's generally not what you want to do. And now red has popped their Uber in response, and those are both pretty much no-nos. We did hear at least 401k goes down to a backstab. So blue medic out of the picture. Red med is going to have that Uber advantage, despite the fact that they really shouldn't have popped there. Red med was pretty well protected. Even though blue did pop and they're just like, hey, we could just reset the Ubers. But in general, you don't want to pop your Uber on either side on A. Because A is a formality, really. A is just get this and let's get to the real points. Because A is difficult to defend. As you can see, there's no real good sentry gun placement. And that's why most engineers will just go for B. And we do have blue doing a good job carving out some space here and finally getting some presence on the point. Red's still contesting this quite a bit, and Once in Future King goes down, and this is where you generally want to fall back, just give up the point and cut your losses, and that is what Red Team is doing right here. So point is stacked and it does go to High on Frags. And now we'll get to the Drowning Butter cam as he pokes his head, and he's got a nice shot at the sentry gun position, and that sentry gun, oh man, if only he had the direct hit, but he did not. That's of course, yeah. So we do have the Uber popped, sentry gun goes down anyway, it took enough damage from the regular rocket launcher. In comes High on Frags, it's a nice push, but they need to follow it up with some kills right here. Oh, and they know that Uber is coming. They did not do a good job really engaging blue team. They popped Uber, I think, a little early, but now falling back, and we'll have to try to do this again. They're going to have a little bit of Uber advantage, but probably won't be utilizing it. It's such a small advantage, and usually at Steel level, you just don't have teams that in tune with that sort of advantage. Oh man, we're not going to have too much sniper cam because Creme Brulee is rocking the huge air thing on his head. Also having a bit of trouble with this Heavy, who is doing a lot of spamming, but I feel good about this next shot for Creme Brulee. No, doesn't matter though, his team is pushing onto the point. Times five on B right here, and it looks like they will be able to capture it as Red has again fallen back. Key to Steel defense on, oh look, Johnny and Butter switched to the direct hit. But the key to defense on Steel is knowing when to fall back and when you can't. I mean, that's really the key to defense on any Highlander map is knowing when to fall back. And we do have a pretty strong defense here going on C. Engineer is building too, and that's usually you don't see that. Oh, Creme Brulee's got a 5k streak going on. Just took down Spooky Senpai right there. But yeah, this is not a great sentry gun position, and we have, yeah, see, not great sentry gun positions from Jimmy Hat right now. I think at this time, most engineers would fall back to E and put a level 3 sentry gun on E. Ubers are popped. We're going to have the little awkward Uber dance. Too bad there's no pyro to do some air blasting, but Blue does fall back well enough. Got to watch out for that blue sniper. Creme Brulee has been doing some nice work. Oh, not able to do anything right there. And of course, once we do get on his camera, he's gonna die. So we won't even bother. Where is that red combo? Was just nowhere there to help the demo man survive. And he went down pretty easily right there. Blue, sensing that this is their time, are going to be making this move. Ferris Nova was not gonna survive that. And Jimmy Hat did fall back to E for the build, which is a good idea, but right now Blue is rapidly seizing C right here. MF Doom lost his medic. Oh man, and Johnny and Butter taking down Spooky Senpai right there as well. Hero Protagonist went down right before that, so MF Doom is trying to survive, and he will get away from that darned mini sentry, but right now only four up for $200 bullets, and they gotta put together some scrappy defense right here on D, and it looks like it's MF Doom with still trying to get out of this. Oh wow, he does actually get Drowning in Butter, who peeked a little too far, but it looks like they kind of want to just wait and get this. Oh, what? Totally not a bot. Peeked too far there too. So some overextension really working out in favor of $200 bullets. Uber is forced right there. So again, some nice work just poking out of their spawn from $200 bullets, really making it work, and some not great plays out of high on frags. Really should have flashed that Uber to get by that spawn. And when you're camping in spawn, it means that or when people in spawn are trying to get you, whatever, it means that the point is open, and they really should have been using that opportunity to make use of steals. Many ways of getting around. We do see that they are trying to get some time on E right now. That sentry gun is down. Timmy Hat is rebuilding as fast. Jimmy Hat, sorry. As fast as he can, but he is just constantly being spammed. He does have that dispenser there, but he needs some support, and it may not happen. Yeah, everything is just dissolving as soon as he builds it. Nice kill right there from Tater to take out the Spy, but Spy is dead, ringing out of that, and it's going to be a big pest for this poor Engie. Jimmy Hat does get Matt manned, so no Engie, but not able to take care of that Spy. In comes Red Uber to just clear off E. They need this breath, but they really need to get this Spy because, oh no, down goes Hero Protagonist, and let's get on the Spy cam. Maybe, perhaps, did he die? Yes, Farron, no, other Spy. This is not working out. Fish fillet. There we go. Okay, now he's no longer in position to do anything interesting. But we do have something interesting here. It is 401k on the crits. So, really interesting right there. They obviously feel good about taking out this sentry gun without an Uber. And so we're going to rely on a crits to get the kills to really give them room. So we're going to go third person cam and just see how this works. In comes the sap. Fish fillet does get it down, but he does not get the stab down, so Engie easily repairing that, but this crits is ready, so I'm wondering what are we gonna do right here. Maybe a little distraction play from Alkias, but he gets taken down by T-Nasty, and this crit's still holding. T-Nasty is patrolling this area right here, doing a good job harassing the sniper, but that mini sentry comes out, and that's oh so painful. In comes the crits. Oh, that just shoots PHZ down into the abyss. Not exactly sure what the idea with the crits was there, except I guess Fish Fillet was a little too late on his sap. Sentry gun did go down, but Timmy, as I call him, Jimmy Hat is not an engineer that gives up easily. Finally, he gets blown up, and that's going to probably mean the end of this defense for Red. Red, the rest of the team just has been not able to get in here, and of course, they still have the open spawn doors because D has not yet been capped. But for a while there, it was just the engineer, which leads me to think they were off doing something else, and then I just wasn't on their camera. But in comes these reinforcements, and they actually may hold this for a little bit longer, at least. I do want to get some sniper shots. Oh, Creme Brulee gets taken down by Nim right there, who got the jump on him. We do see that 401k is he still in the crits? Still in the crits. I do not like that idea. It did not work for them last time. And if they do stay on the crits, which, I mean, they're going to stay on the crits, they need to use a different a route, because there's a sentry gun building up there rapidly, and Jimmy's going to get it soon. So they need to come in from D, which is presently where everybody is holding. Well, the DE connector, at least. So Blue definitely needs to get DE connector, and looks like they're trying for that now. Crits is about 80%, but they do have an Uber waiting for them on the other side. So they are shy from what happened earlier, which was them getting caught out as Red just retreated safely into their spawn every now and then. And that's exactly what we're seeing here right now. They pop the crits and put down some crit stickies, but the Uber is popped right here for Red to come in and defend, and it looks like that Uber is going to reign supreme, as Uber versus crits usually does. So it's a good idea from Hero, and he's heavy MF Doom, to just stay in spawn right there, wait for that crits to fade away, and pop Uber to defend the point. It's not a very aggressive position, and it's tricky because, you know, one crit sticky gets into spawn and you have nowhere to go, really, because it's such an enclosed space. But they were lucky, and I feel like a lot of players steal both the league and the map is a lot of luck. So we'll see. That poor sentry gun is no. Actually, Jimmy gets a Rescue Ranger bow on it, and it does stay up for a little bit longer at least. 401k almost has his crits again. So let's get in on the PHZ cam. See, oh no, that crits has popped. It's a panic crits, and that's never good. Although some long-range stickies might be able to do the job right here. PHZ did get Spooky Sensei, and now he's just going to spam out this sentry gun. He needs the help from somebody. Finally, it does go down. Drowning in Butter actually is the killer there, and I was just about to say he needs the help from a certain direct hit soldier, and Drowning in Butter was there. So down goes the sentry gun, only four up right now for defense, and one of them is a spy who's not gonna survive that. Everybody knew he was coming in. Oh no, worst case scenario for Blue right here. It's an Ubered Pyro on point E, and Tater Dude just has way too much fun putting people on fire and blasting them everywhere. So clutch last minute defense. He does go down to a backstab, and then Hero Protagonist went down to Flare. So only two up right now. One of them is MF Doom, but he is super hurt and goes down to a snipe. Creme Brulee is back on his streak. He's got seven kills going right now. PHC could use a Crusader's crossbow. Oh man, he is okay. He's getting those heals, and it looks like this, I've said it like seven times before in this round, but this will be the time that Blue caps it, unless another Uber Pyro. Nope, that will be it. Oh, Spy Ferris Nova was in position, but not able to do anything right there. So time of 11 minutes and 20 seconds. Not a great time. Yeah. Several things that High on Frags did wrong right there, and I think the hesitancy to use that DE connector after they got completely wiped that one time was part of that, and the decision to use crits and then try going through the main way through E was not the best idea, but I mean they eventually got it, so there's that. But so it's going to be pretty, well, I don't know. I mean, 11 minutes and 20 seconds, I've definitely seen much longer times here on Steel. Shortest time I've ever seen on Steel is had to be like 2 minutes or something when they went just straight for E, and it's those types of things are a thing of beauty. And I saw it at a very high level European Highlander play, so it wasn't just some iron scrim that they're fooling around with, but it can happen. We'll see if it happens here, but of course when you have 11 minutes and 20 seconds to do it, there's really no reason for a crazy E push. So we do see that the engineer is set up on B, as per custom would dictate. And we'll see what else is going on here. We do have a jump in from Once and Future King. Some spam coming over the edge. Ooh, interesting. I like it. We have a level 3 sentry gun out on offense. And, oh man, that was close. But a nice attempt at a reflect sentry gun rocket right there, which I have been killed by my own sentry gun rocket. You feel such a sense of betrayal from this machine that you put your heart and soul into, and then suddenly it kills you. Anyway, that's not getting any action, but we do see the point getting capped a little bit. I believe that was T-Nasty. Uber is popped here. 401k took a ton of damage. I'm going to assume it was maybe he got sniped or something, was feeling nervous. Maybe it was the Once a Future King with a bomb in there. Here is a bomb by an angry demo man and his pyro friend. We'll see, did they catch the medic out? No, medic, it looks like 401k got away alive. But this, oh, and hero barely gets away alive too, 60 health left, and will survive to help his team cap. And yeah, you can see that Red has definitely given up that defense on A once everybody is there. I love the sentry gun by Jimmy. I love the level 3 on offense on steel, because you can just your enemy so unawares. Ferris Nova is having trouble finishing off this dang sniper. Finally gets the poke on him. He's not going to survive all that sticky damage, but sniper out of the picture is good enough. T-Nasty already going to go for some time here on E. Not a bad idea. I did see he was accompanied by Once and Future King, who was coming in from behind and gets a 2K, taking out PHC. He does go down to Alcaeus right there. Or Alcaeus? I don't know. But T-Nasty is still in the hunt. And look at that great defense he's got. Whenever he needs more health, he just falls back to lobby right there where his engineer is set up. And meanwhile, he can just pick away. Meanwhile, we also have quite a bit of action going on for this offensive push onto B. Just completely annihilating High on Frags right now. They didn't have an Uber, and that definitely hurt them. I think they didn't have an Uber, but regardless, Uber from Hero was much better. So now it is desperation time. PHC realizes there's a level 3 sentry gun in a place that his team really needs to control in order to put up 8 more minutes of defense. Right now, though, it's not looking great. They're going for a C defense, but I really think that their attention should be directed to E, considering there's now a level 3 underground out of a lobby right there and pointed at the point. A little wrangling action I think is necessary, and Jimmy is reading my mind, and all he has to do is sit there with this wrangler and just not get sniped, and E's team is golden. Oh, darn. What did I just tell you, Jimmy? What did I tell you? Oh, nice backstab from Ferris Nova. He got 401k there, too. You saw the pyro and medic coming in from behind. They could do a lot of damage right there, but were taken down. The sentry gun went down after Jimmy went down. That was too bad, but Once a Future King is doing a major amount of work, so I'm just going to get on his cam right there. Once a Future King, I see in lobbies all the time. I'm pretty sure he lives on TF2 Center. And, he is Once and Future, and oh, can he be the current king? Yeah, that was a bad joke, but needs to get one more shot, two more shots. Where is this finally drowning in butter going down, and Once and Future King getting that kill? He's on a bit of a roll right now. If he had a kill streak weapon, I would guess 5 or 6. Oh, but T-Nasty finally comes in from behind and take, or I'm sorry, that was Alcaeus comes in from behind. Now we're on the T-Nasty cam. He's on the point again. Gonna have to, oh, do we have a battle of the level 3 sentry guns? Oh, it's not a battle if one of them already died, but against an excellent sentry gun right there from Jimmy's got a target down. Oh, the sap coming off. Oh, but some nice defense from Nim right there to take down Fish Fillet. But the sentry gun does go down. But there's a level 3 dispenser, and there's everybody right now in lava right here. Blue is looking really good. And they're doing this the hard way. They're going for the decap, which they will be able to get. They don't even need to, because they're in such a good position right here to cap E. D is capped, and then immediately time on E goes down. So this could be it, and this is looking to a very nice time. What a shot by Nim to take down that pesky pyro, or pesky spy. Didn't getting Fizz right there is what I'm sometimes calling him. Can he get the pyro through the window? I mean, eventually he's going to have to go capture the point, but we're going to stick on his cam because he's going a little bit of cray-cray here at the end, and this is one of these great sniper lines that everybody has to come out of this one point And just keep your eye trained there, and you're in good business. Also, you have to watch for behind, but you know what? There's that level 3 sentry gun doing some nice work again. Once in Future King, getting several million kills at once. He's still patrolling. Down goes Alkeus. Medic 41K is still alive. He's bringing out the sword! Or, not the sword, the saw, but it's not going to be enough. Creme Brulee is the only one left alive, and he gets Nim. Oh, Nim is pissed. Nim wanted to be a part of that capture for sure. Fizz now the only one left alive, but he will not be able to get there, and that is a capture and a round win for $200 bullets. A nice round right there from the $200 bullet team. All right, we'll be back with the second half. And like I promised, we're back. When have I ever broken a promise to you, loyal viewers? But we are back with the second half. High on frags needs to make something happen this round, or $200 bullets are going to take it. $200 bullets have the chance to attack first, and I'm excited about this. They seem like a very aggressive team, and I'm not surprised with Once in Future King and some others that I've seen in lobbies too. I've seen Hero Protagonist, and I think a few others. Tater Dude sounds, MF Doom sounds familiar. Or I could just be making this up. Meanwhile, I'm really hungry, and everybody over on High on Frags sounds really delicious, like drowning in butter, a fish fillet, creme brulee. That's oh man, so hungry right now. Anyway, standard defense. Standard offense. We'll see. Is there a level 3 sentry gun ready to be put up on offense? There is! Oh, Jimmy Hat, you know what I like. T-Nasty goes down immediately to a body shot there from Creme Brulee. Oh, Ferris Nova got poked or bumped right there, so he's not going to last long on that B push. But we'll get on the Nim cam as he is pushing forward aggressively right here, trying to get a snipe on a combo. Heavy has disengaged from his medic, down to 8 health right there. Totally not a bot, though. Fell back, but don't worry, Nim still got him. And we'll see how this push goes right here. MF Doom is taking a lot of damage. Smart Heavy, though, he falls back instead of just throwing his life away. Neither Uber has been popped, and that's a little bit more consistent with what you'll see on higher level teams. So Red decided to play this smart and go for a really solid hold here on B, which I think is absolutely the right idea. And we'll see if they can get that hold. Some good sticks coming out here from PHC. He does take down MF Zoom, but the Uber goes off anyway on the Demo Man coming forward right here. And Blue Uber is not going to be able to do anything right here. Oh man, the medic fell back right into Fish Filet. But Hero, oh just kidding, Hero almost got away alive, and then Drowning in Butter came to finish him off. I'm getting a little stuttering, hold on. Alright, that should fix it. We'll see though. And a nice first hold, or I like to call this a first hold because it really is, because they didn't try, most teams don't try too hard on A, like I said before. But a nice first defensive hold here out of High on Frags. And if they can keep this up, they could carve themselves a nice time. But they just have to play smart, and it I believe in them. I just met them, and this is crazy, but I believe in you guys. Lot of action, not a lot, some action going on E, and one of the big mistakes that new teams will make is to rotate everybody around to E. Oh man, totally not a bot, and PHC both overextending right there, and this is not good. The defense has just completely melted away. 41K even has this Uber, he's gonna pop it on his sniper. That was not a good idea, although Creme Brulee just got the medic, so maybe it was. But right now 41K needs to get away alive. He's not going to. Awkward noises, because that was not great defense right there. Medic should have just waited with his Uber. Are they gonna hold this? I look like a jackass. No. Maybe if they can hold this. PHC looks like he is gonna fall back. There's some action already happening. Like that level 3 sentry gun, which we know and love. But PHC's just lets his stickies do the talking, and they have nothing good to say about $200 bullets. I think what's going on B? PHC is going to rotate back there, and we're just going to stick on his cam, because he is Demo Man. Hear him roar, and he can get a few good stickies in there, but no, he's going to take too much damage and fall back. And the time will be 3 minutes and 5 seconds. I really think that defense could have been a better hold right there on E. Oh, 41K cannot die right here. That is not an option. Because he poked his head too much, paid the price, and now he needs to get out of there. Just play cautiously and wait for that blue Uber to push into them. I would like to see Gotham with that combo for when that blue Uber does come. It looks like he is making that rotation over to C. Again, we do see the sentry gun on C defense. And we'll give it a shot. It is level 3 right now, and that's, I think that's... Oh yeah, the first time we saw it. I'm not... Usually teams don't put a level 3 sentry gun. Oh my god, 401k has 97 health left. I mean, 97% Uber and 330 health left. He does get the Uber pop off. Can't flash his heavy in time, but he was going down to a headshot anyway. We'll have to watch for this jumping soldier. Drowning Butter does survive, though. I thought for a second that was Once in Future King, but no. That is a friendly soldier right there for Red. So a nice... A nice-ish hold right there. I'm just really concerned about this sentry gun. So is Ferris Nova, just scouting everything out, even though that's not his role. His role is to spy everything out. And here he is scouting things out. But we'll see. I'm conflicted about the sentry gun because nobody usually no one builds on C. But we'll see what's going on E. What is going on in E is T-Nasty and his soldier buddy, Once in Future King, trying to get some time there on the point and wildly succeeding because Nim is getting even some good protection. Looks like Once in Future King still alive. And what is going on? How is he still alive? He's dodging like a boss. He must be getting healed from far away. Finally, he goes down. But it doesn't matter because the scout is there. We'll finish off the cap. That's T-Nasty, scout and soldiers, buddies forever. That's a time of 5 minutes and 7 seconds. And wow. I think that's the problem with committing too much of your defense to C. Is you leave nothing for E. And what we saw there is $200 boots wisely taking... advantage of that. Just E was pretty wide open except for a few lighter classes because the heavy medic combo and demo were all holding at C right there, and it takes longer to rotate around than to get back to the point. Ooh, this is interesting. So yeah, little bit of missteps, but definitely not all over right yet for High on Frags, especially since they pulled out the crits. I am excited. See what they can do with this. We saw them pull it out on offense earlier, but it was more of a desperation or of a frustration. We can't do anything. Let's just do crits type thing. But crits on rollout, basically, is an interesting maneuver. If they charge up a crit sticky and get in the right place, they could force the enemy to drop Uber. Oh... That just happened. Oh, when you're trying a sneaky move, make sure the enemy team has not also tried a sneaky move, meaning sticky traps in the perfect position to take down 401k right as he popped that crits. Oh man, what a trap right there by Spooky Senpai. PhD is not going to survive this. 401k is going to try to build and get this crits up soon, but he's going to be bombed right here by Once in Future King. Alkius does take care of him, despite the fact that he has this huge air thing on his head. Of course, we're the only ones that can see it because we're special. Uber is not yet been popped by Red. Here is just hanging on and hanging back, which of course is proper technique. He's got to watch out that he's not spammed out. And PhD is putting a lot of spam right there. This would probably be the best time to fall back and give up this point. But with a time of 5 minutes, they could feasibly pop this Uber and still be in an okay position. And it looks like that's at least what MF's Doom wants to do. He fell down there. His medic didn't follow. Hero's like, you're on your own, buddy. I'm not popping this Uber. Not for all the tea in China. Maybe for all the tea in China. I don't know. And that will be the cap. Hero did survive, but he's the only one alive. Tater Dude is up too. And it's just them hanging out at B. Sentry gun's up, so that's good news. Don't know how the sentry gun stayed up if the NG is, you can see, down. I really don't like this position. Oh! I see this? See this? That's good NG work. Jimmy spawned, he knew that his sentry gun was firing or taking damage, so he immediately wrangled it to help protect it. It gets zapped and gets taken down, but that's a good engineer heads-up play. But in general, yeah, that's a crappy place to have your sentry gun when you're not alive. It's a good place to have it, and when you can, like, pull it back with the Rescue Ranger, but right now it's just too far forward and easily taking spam, as he can't even get anything up again. We do have both Ubers ready. Either team has yet to pop it. E is being capped a little bit, so red needs to pop. Yeah, blue though should. Oh my god, they cannot drop. It's crits! Why are they still running crits? Oh my goodness. They should have popped that crits ages ago. I should have noticed that it was crits ages ago. They do take down Hero. Hero actually gets sniped right there. And only three up for this defensive team. So we'll see if High on Frags can do this. They have the demo man. And look what we got going on here with Madman taking a page out of the book of Jimmy. That level 3 sentry gun, oh boy, gets backstabbed. And that festive sapper goes down. Not going to be able to survive that. Got a good blue presence right here. They haven't even captured B, but they're already capping E. Might be able to... They need to shut down this spawn, and once in Future King is coming in from behind. Good flanking procedure right there to get the clear that point off and then allow his team to come out of spawn, because they are just being camped. Not really camped, but kind of camped. Squashed in there. It was unpleasant. I think we can all agree that that would be a word. 41K, what... Okay. No, I don't understand this. They're obviously going for an E push right now, because as you can see, B is nowhere near and being capped. They have a minute and 15 seconds left. That is enough time to get an Uber up. Oh my goodness, that is also enough time to get backstabbed, which Ferris Nova does do courtesy of totally not a bot. This quick fix is open, and 41K does pop and try to just get up in the face of Once and Future King, which he succeeds in taking out, but in comes this Uber, and quick fix versus Uber never goes in the way of quick. Well, sometimes it might. It might once in a while. I mean, I think the intention with the quick fix was to get the medic on the point so he could therefore heal people who were capturing the point, but you gotta get through the massive amounts of defensive players first, and Quick Fix is not gonna be able to do that versus an Uber, which you just saw right there. Only 30 seconds left, and it's not possible to capture E in that amount of time. And fortunately, no overtime here for High on Frags, because the time has already been set. $200 bullets doing a nice job setting that fast time, really secured. I mean, not absolutely secure, because it was close here at the end, but really gave them a good shot at winning this round once in Future King. Oh boy, I'm glad I caught that on camera, but that is going to be a round win and a victory for $200 bullets. Congratulations, guys. Nice attempts right there from High on Frags, and I like their I like that they were thinking outside the box with that opening crits. It's too bad that there is a massive sticky trap waiting for them. Anyway, thanks so much to Hero Protagonist who sent this in. Shout out to Once in Future King for being a literary reference. And that is about it for me, guys. Thanks so much for watching. Have a good day.